A delegation from South Korea is visiting Pierce County's felony drug court. Megan Hutton explains what it is about our sentencing and treatment program that's gaining worldwide attention.
A group of 20 delegates from South Korea are here to watch, to ask questions.
I'd like to know the degrees to make a decision to send to jail or to come to this court.
Pierce County's felony drug court program began 20 years ago. It gives low-level offenders, many with property crimes, an alternative. Agree to a year or more of rigorous classes, treatment, and court monitoring in exchange for staying out of jail.
If they come in and they're successful, the criminal charges that were pending against them would be dismissed. And so that's kind of the motivation for them.
In South Korea, drug use is on the rise. Their court system imposes jail time, but there's no treatment program. And they saw that Pierce County's method is working. You have to stop the addiction to stop reoffenders.
Our recidivism rate is one of the best there is, and we track that for 4 years after they graduate.
Rochelle will graduate from drug court just before her 23rd birthday after 3 years in the program.
You know how long you've been with us?
A long time.
A long time.
3 years, I think.
And it hasn't been easy for you, has it?
If you had not successfully completed drug court, where would you be going?
Probably to prison.
Michael has 5 excellent reviews in a row and has been clean for more than a year.
And so I'm just focusing on how to do the next right thing and how to be the next, the man I really want to be.
For others, accountability comes one step at a time.
As far as my recovery goes, I am 135 days today, and I attend my meetings.
It's a comprehensive approach to drug and alcohol treatment.
We help them get their driver's license back. We help them find jobs. We find housing for them. We get them set up so that they can start out and be successful, and that follows them through the program.
A program the South Korean delegation is hoping to implement back home.
It does save a lot of money. It's a better way to go. Not only do we keep people out of jail and prisons, but we give them a new life.
You bet.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.